I'm Anna, I'm an Azure Technical Trainer, and in this video we will be speaking about the DP100 and DP090 course, where we learn how to design and implement a data science solution on Azure. I like teaching this course because we do lots of hands-on labs, we do lots of whiteboarding sessions and interactive discussions, we have a look at use cases that are closer to the real-life use case scenarios, and we're also working a lot with the machine learning pipelines, and we're building lots of interesting and cool stuff out there. The most cool part with the DP100 is that we are going to learn about the Azure Machine Learning workspace, the data sets, experiments, machine learning workflows and pipelines, which operationalize the machine learning workflows. Then we learn about the training and inferencing the models that we trained in different ways. For example, we are going to learn about the real-time inferencing, we are going to learn about the batch inferencing to do the asynchronous predictions. In DP090, we're going to learn about the Azure Machine Learning and in Azure Databricks service, where we leverage the in-memory processing in Apache Spark in order to run the machine learning much faster. Let's have a deeper look at the module 2 in the instructor-led training, where we learn about the visual tools for Azure Machine Learning. In the instructor-led course, we're going to look into a classification model, which we are going to train and inference. In the Microsoft Learn Learning Path, which is covering the same subject, you will find a bit of more theory, which you can use as a book to read and understand better the metrics behind the scenes and the algorithms that we are going to use. In addition to that, you will find some extra exercises on regression and clustering model training and inferencing. In other words, you can use the Microsoft Learn Learning Path as a book and a reference to get more exercises and more theory about what you have trained and tried in the lab. Before coming to class, for a more smooth and comfortable training experience, I would suggest having a look at the Microsoft Learn Learning Paths. For example, have a look at some differences between the supervised versus unsupervised learning. Have a look at the deep learning techniques, for example, the frameworks like PyTorch, TensorFlow, Keras. Have a look at some of the Python packages that we're going to be constantly using in the labs in the instructor-led training. For example, you could have a look at the NumPy package, at the libraries like scikit-learn, and those are things that you are going to be using a lot in the labs in the instructor-led training. After the training, if you are prepping for the exam, I would suggest having a look at the learning paths at Microsoft Learn about the data science, and also check out the Measure Up official study guide for the exam, because you will find all the subjects that will be covered in the exam in that study guide. And of course, it never stops there. If you'd like to take this one step further and learn a bit more about other data solutions on Microsoft Azure Stack, you could go for the DP203 training, where you will learn how to do the ETL-ELT transformations and different services that you could use there in order to bring the data into your machine learning service. So thanks everybody for watching, hope to see you around, and good luck everyone who's preparing for the exam.